Welcome to MOOC lecture on Strategy and Introduction to Game Theory. In this module, I'm going to emphasize two assumptions which are basic foundation of game theory. Those two assumptions are rationality, that players are rational and they have common knowledge. Soon it will become clear what do we mean by these terms. But before we do so, let us just think about what is game theory. You have been doing game theory for 2 weeks. What do we mean by game theory? That game theory is analysis of a strategic interaction in which outcome for each agent depends on not only his or her own action, but also choices made by others. So the key term is that choices that are made by others have to be taken into consideration. So study of rational behavior in interactive or interdependent setting is game theory. Now we have been talking about mass equilibrium and other solution concept, but all those solution concept, for that we have to think about two concepts first, two assumptions first. Those assumptions are rationality and common knowledge. So before we talk about rationality, game theory is basically, it's a study in rational choice theory according to economics. So what do we mean by rational choice theory? The theory of rational choice is that a decision maker chooses the best action according to her preferences among all the actions available to her. You might be wondering that we are getting a lot of new terms, but when we learn a subject, it's important to understand the jargon that comes with that subject. What do we mean by preference? We will soon come to that, what do we mean by preference? Basically, rationality, if we try to understand it in day-to-day term, rationality is all about consistency in decision making. If one person is consistent, rationality doesn't mean that he likes one thing over the other thing. It's not about likes and dislikes. It's about consistency in decision making. And also the term preference, what do we mean by preference? Basically, preference gives us the notion of at least as good as. Like when I say I prefer coffee to tea, what I mean that I like coffee at least as much as tea, but not tea as much as coffee. Okay? So preference is basically a relation that gives us the notion of at least as good as. So coming back to rationality, now we know what do we mean by preference. Coming back to rationality, rationality simply says that preference have to satisfy two criteria. One is of completeness, another is of transitivity. What do we mean by completeness? Let us say when you have two choices, choice A or choice B. You should be able to say that choice A is better than choice B, or choice B is better than choice A. Or you should be able to say that you are indifferent between choice A and choice B. When you could do that, then one can say that your preference is complete. You might be wondering, didn't we cover all the possibility? But let me tell you one scenario in which your preference would not be complete. Given choice between, let us say, this A and this B, when you are unable to decide, not because you like both of them equally, but you are unable to decide, you are not clear about what you like, then your preference is not complete. So one thing that we should understand, for rationality, your preference has to be complete. What does it mean? That given options, given two options at a time, you should be able to decide which one you want. The second requirement that we have is of transitivity. Completeness is about able to make decision. Transitivity is about consistency. So what does it say? That preferences are transitive if a consumer who prefers basket A or item A to item B and item B to item C, then he should prefer item A to item C. Fine? Okay? Let us take three examples. What we have? Mango. Then we have a banana. And then we have a guava. three things. What it says, if you prefer mango to banana and banana to guava, then you should prefer guava, you should prefer mango to guava. This is also possible that you may not prefer in this manner. What it is also possible that you prefer mango to banana and banana to guava, but given a choice between guava and mango, you pick guava. In this case, your choice would not be consistent. This is what we want to avoid. Why do we want to avoid? Because if your decision making is not consistent, then it's impossible to figure out which decision you will make. There is another problem also. Let us say that, of course, you like mango to banana, and the difference you are willing to pay to exchange, you to get mango in lieu of a banana, you are willing to give 1 rupees. And again, if you want to get banana in lieu of guava, you are willing to pay 1 rupee. And again, between guava and mango, again, you are willing to pay 1 rupee. So let us say that you have a mango at present. I bring a guava. I say, would you like to take guava? Because you are willing to pay at least as much as 1 rupee and guava for that mango, I will give you my guava. What you will do? You will give me a mango and 1 rupee. Now, what do? I bring a banana, and between banana and guava, you like banana more. So again, you will be willing to pay 1 rupee. You will give me guava as well as 1 rupee. Now you will have a banana. Remember, I had your mango. I will bring that mango back to you. And between mango and banana, you will take that mango, give me the banana and 1 rupee. Eventually, now you again have the mango that you started with, but you have 3 rupees less. So that kind of situation we would like to avoid. So we say that all the players should be rational. It means they are able to make decision and they are consistent in their decision making. So these are the two requirements. Now what we have, the second assumption that we require is of common knowledge. It sounds funny, but bear with me. I will come to an example and you will understand it better. What is common knowledge? Let us say there is a fact that is known by each player. Each player knows X. Next requirement for common knowledge is that each player knows X. It doesn't stop here. It goes further that each player knows X. Let me do one more time. That each player knows X. And we can't stop here. We have to go on till infinity. We will have to keep on doing that. It may sound funny, but let us take an example. Let us consider the fact, a story, that Ram and Syam plan to meet at India Gate. Again, this is a made up example. You don't have to, Ram and Syam and India Gate are not important. It's just the fact. Ram came to know that India Gate is closed today for some security reason. So he sends a SMS to Syam saying, let us meet at Rajiv Chowk, Metro Gate number 1 at 7 p.m. in the evening. Syam receives the SMS and confirms that he would come there at 7 p.m. Syam reaches to gate number 1 at 7 p.m. but does not find Ram there. Syam may think that Ram didn't receive the message. Let us use the definition of common knowledge in this setting. What is the fact? The fact is that they are supposed to meet, X is that they are supposed to meet at Rajiv Chowk, Metro Gate number 1 at 7 p.m. Let us consider this X. Ram knows that they are supposed to meet at Metro Gate number 1 at 7 p.m. Why? Because Ram is the one who messaged Syam first. So Ram knows this. Syam also knows this. Why? Because he received the message. Let us go to the next step. Ram knows that Syam knows this, that they are supposed to meet at Metro Gate number 1 at 7 p.m. Why? How can we say that Ram knows that Syam knows? Because Ram sent this message to Syam, okay? And Syam replied back. How about Syam? Does Syam know that Ram knows that they are supposed to meet at metro station? Yes, Syam knows because Ram is the one who sent him the message. So Syam also knows, so second step is clear. How about the third step? that Ram knows that the Syam knows that the Ram knows that they are supposed to meet at metro station at 7 p.m. Yes, Ram knows because Ram received a confirmation from Syam. But let us look at from the Syam's point of view. Does Syam know that Ram knows that Syam knows that they are supposed to meet at metro station? No, that's where it breaks down. So it doesn't fulfill the requirement for common knowledge. So that we have to be careful. So in game theory, we assume that players have common knowledge. They know, they all know the rules of the game. They all know the payoffs. Not only they know the payoffs and rules of the game, they know that the other players also knows. And not, we can't stop there. They know that all other players know, that all other players know the payoffs and rule of the game, and so on. So in game theory, we have this requirement. Just to make it clear, what do we mean by knowledge? That I know X, that is my knowledge. What is mutual knowledge? That each of us know X. And from mutual knowledge, we go to common knowledge, that each of us knows, that each of us knows, that each of us knows, to, and you can keep on talking about it. Fine. So these are the two assumptions required for game theory, rationality as well as common knowledge. Okay. Now, in the next module, we are going to use some of these things that we have learned.